subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yishi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 1st of September. Schools reopen in several Indian states after months gap strict COVID rules. We are on the path of peace, says Taliban after US exit from Afghanistan. And probe reveals police in Pakistan's Karachi running dens of narcotics. And now for all the details. Schools and colleges in at least six more Indian states and union territories, including national capital New Delhi, reopened from Wednesday in a gradual manner, with health measures in place. Local authorities cited the considerable drop in coronavirus cases across the country for reopening of schools, despite the looming fear of a potential third wave of coronavirus cases. Adhering to COVID-19 protocols, schools in Indian capital New Delhi reopened for students of 9 to 12 standards on Wednesday, almost 1.5 years after educational institutions were shut down due to a spike in the infections. Students from various schools were seen enthusiastic and excited over the resumption of physical classes. The schools were ordered shut in the national capital in March 2020 after a spike in COVID-19 cases. Colleges, universities and coaching institutions have also been allowed to reopen in a phased manner.
हमने एक्सपर्ट्स से बात करके, हमने पेरेंट्स से बात करके स्कूल खोले हैं और आसपास के राज्यों में जो माहौल रहा है, क्योंकि दिल्ली में स्कूल खोलने का डिसीजन कई और राज्यों के बाद में लिया गया है, तो वहां के एक्सपीरियंस को देख के भी, वहां से भी हमने सीखा है, उसी हिसाब से हमने प्रोटोकॉल्स बनाए हैं.
In northern Varanasi and Gorakhpur cities of Uttar Pradesh state, schools also reopened for students from class 1 to 5. Classes 6 to 12 have already reopened in the state earlier with 50% capacity. Students were elated to be back to school after a long time. Several enthusiastic students wearing masks were seen making a beeline for the schools.
स्कूल में आके अच्छा लग रहा है और जो है घर पे रह के पढ़ाई अच्छे से नहीं हो पाती थी, यहाँ पे आए हैं तो मैम लोग अच्छे से पढ़ा भी देंगी और क्वेश्चन भी समझा देंगी, इसलिए यहाँ पे पढ़ाई ठीक होगी.
स्कूल्स इन सदर्न इंडिया इंक्लूडिंग तेलंगाना स्टेट आल्सो रीओपेंड अमिड स्ट्रिक्ट कोविड-19 प्रिकॉशंस इंक्लूडिंग वेयरिंग मास्क, सैनिटाइजेशन, सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग अमंग अदर्स. व्हाइल क्लासेस 8 टू 12 रीओपेंड, ऑनलाइन क्लासेस विल आल्सो कंटिन्यू एट द सेम टाइम. Meanwhile, India reported 41,956 new coronavirus cases and 460 deaths in the last 24 hours. With this, India's total COVID case load has risen to 32.8 million and active cases presently stand at 378,181. India achieved a new vaccination milestone on Tuesday with the administering of over 13 million doses in a day. Heavy rainfall continued to throw normal life out of gear on Wednesday in parts of northern India. The downpour in national capital New Delhi and its neighbouring areas since early morning caused waterlogging and huge traffic jams, giving a hard time to daily commuters to reach their destinations.
Heavy rains and subsequent deluge on Wednesday continued to throw normal life out of gear in parts of northern India, causing waterlogging and traffic chaos. Streets in Mathura city of Uttar Pradesh state were seen heavily waterlogged and several residential colonies and low-lying areas were seen inundated due to flooding. Meanwhile, incessant rainfall since the early hours of Wednesday turned roads into pools in national capital New Delhi and neighbouring Gurugram city and caused traffic snarls stretching for hours, giving a hard time to the commuters to reach their destinations. The India Meteorological Department issued an orange alert for New Delhi for the day, predicting moderate rain accompanied with thunder showers.
पर मुझे अकेले जाना यहीं पे है, लेकिन पिछले आधे घंटे से मैं इतना ही दूर में फंसा हूँ. उस गोल चक्कर पे गया था, वहाँ पे ट्रैफिक मूव कर रखा है पानी की वजह से, इधर में आया उधर में ये पेड़ गिर गया हुआ है।
विद वाइड स्प्रेड कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड रबिश क्लॉग ड्रेन्स एंड वाटरवेज, मोस्ट ऑफ सबर्बन इंडिया स्ट्रगल्स एवरी ईयर इन मॉनसून एज रेन्स मेक देम इंक्रीजिंगली वल्नरेबल टू फ्लडिंग, while civic administrations often fail to cope with challenges posed by them.
Moving on to news from Afghanistan. Taliban spokesman Zabihullah Mujahid has said that Afghanistan's new rulers are on the path of peace and want good relations with all nations following US exit from the country after almost 20 years, which US President Joe Biden has defended by saying it was in the US national interest. Meanwhile, amid an administrative vacuum following the Taliban's takeover, Taliban members were out on the streets of Kabul to protect people's property and lives, a member said on Wednesday.
Taliban members were out on the streets of Afghan capital Kabul to protect people's property and lives, a member said on Wednesday, amid an administrative vacuum following the Taliban's takeover. The Islamist militia have focused on keeping banks, hospitals and government machinery running after the final withdrawal of US forces brought an end to massive airlift of Afghans who had helped Western nations during the 20-year war. The Taliban have yet to name a new government or reveal how they intend to govern.
او دلته د دې خاطر راغلی اوس د خلکو مال او د ناموس او د عزت خیال وساتو د دوی امنیت وساتو او دلته موږ په دې راغلی اوس د بیت المال سره خیانت ونسي د خلکو د مال او د ژوند زندگی د دو سر مال ټول حفاظت وکړو د دې لپاره راغلی او ولس ته دا ډاډ ورکړو چې دوی به سر مال عزت ټول په اطمینان کې د دوی به په حفاظت کې دا د موږ دوی لپاره پیغام ده.
Following the withdrawal of the last US troops, Taliban spokesman Zabihullah Mujahid said on Tuesday, Afghanistan's new rulers are on the path of peace and want good relations with all nations, including the United States. Mujahid also called on the international community to cooperate with us politically. US Secretary of State Antony Blinken said the United States was prepared to work with the new Taliban government if it did not carry out reprisals against opponents. Earlier, US President Joe Biden took responsibility for the tumultuous US evacuation from Afghanistan, saying it was the best available option.
Last night in Kabul,
Biden criticized the ousted Afghan government's inability to fight back against swift Taliban advances, which forced the United States and its NATO allies into a hasty and humiliating exit, and highlighted the role played by the former US President Donald Trump. The deal brokered by Trump authorized the release of 5,000 prisoners last year, including some of the Taliban's top war commanders among those who just took control, Biden said.
In news from Pakistan, as the US war in Afghanistan came to an end and Taliban seized control over the war-torn country, Afghan refugees who have been living in Pakistan for years are divided over whether to return to their homeland under the new rule and are divided over the move.
With Taliban taking control of Afghanistan following the withdrawal of the last US troops on Tuesday, Afghan refugees who have been living in Pakistan for years are divided over when to go home to Afghanistan. The Khorasan refugee camp on the outskirts of Peshawar was built during the Afghan war and is home to over 400 families, with some residents having been there for over 30 years. Decades of war have driven Afghans out of their country, most into Pakistan to the east and Iran to the west.
تلار شو خپل وطن ما باچی مونږ ته خپل زینا اباچی وطن ما باچی نو خپل وطن خپل وطنیا تلتم دا دیش کال زندگی پدې پاکی په خاور تیر کړ نو موږ چې واپس بیرته لاړ خپل وطن
هلته تک په الحال نه غالو هلته تک ولیکن هلته اوس نوی حکومت دی کله چې موږ هلته به یو سیستم برابر شي بینکونه به کلو شي کاروبار خلق شروع وکړي اوس خلق ټول یره کې دي او تښتېدو کې دي هر ملک ته هر یو خپل ځان وباسي او یره وجنه څوک کار کول کوم یو کارخانه فکتریان دي هغه ټول بند دي او کوم یو کاروبار شروع شي هغه بس نور وروسته به وګورو کنه.
Pakistan is home to 1.4 million Afghan refugees, while Iran hosts nearly a million, according to UN Refugee Agency data from the beginning of the year. Meanwhile, Afghan refugees in India fear they are concerned about those who were left behind in the war-torn country under Taliban's rule. Some say Taliban fighters will spread terror and impose strict restrictions on Afghans, especially women. Also on Tuesday, Afghan refugees staged a sit-in protest outside the United Nations Refugee Agency office, calling for refugee cards and resettlement option to a third country, as well as more security.
More news from Pakistan. An internal probe by Pakistan's Sindh police has found that at least 363 narcotics dens are being run and supervised by police officers in Karachi, ringing alarm bells for the law and order situation in the country's largest city.
An internal probe report prepared by Pakistan's Sindh police has found that at least 363 narcotics dens are being run and supervised by police officers in Karachi, ringing alarm bells for the law and order situation in the country's largest city. According to local media reports, the probe has identified involvement of over 100 police officers, ranking from constables to deputy superintendents, who collect millions of rupees from these dens. A separate district-wise list of the policemen in dens has been prepared. So far, all the cops named in the report in Karachi's Korangi district have been suspended, while 8 policemen have been suspended in Malir district. This is not the first time. An earlier report prepared by the special branch in 2013 had also highlighted involvement of police officers in running dens of narcotics and gambling. This comes days after Syed Murad Ali Shah, the chief minister of Sindh province, had ordered an operation against the drug mafia while presiding over a meeting to review the law and order situation on August 25.
In news from Nepal, 10 CPN UML provincial assembly lawmakers and a parallel committee in Cascade district have chosen to side with the newly formed CPN Unified Socialist Party led by Madhav Kumar Nepal, reports suggest. This comes as the Election Commission has given a deadline till September 7 to elected people's representatives of the CPN UML and the JSP to choose their party. Madhav Kumar Nepal had registered his new political party on August 25 after parting ways with CPN UML led by KP Sharma Oli. He blamed Oli for exercising autocratic principles and announced his party will join Prime Minister Sher Bahadur Deoba's coalition government. Meanwhile, Deoba was scheduled to hold a meeting to expand his cabinet later in the day. The move has been delayed so far due to disagreements over power sharing. The Indian Railways has launched a jungle tea toy train safari in the picturesque Eastern Himalayan Valley in West Bengal state in an attempt to boost tourism. The train journey offers breathtaking views of Mahananda Wildlife Sanctuary and local tea party on the train itself.
In an attempt to boost the tourism, Northern East Frontier Railways in India launched a regular jungle tea toy train safari in the picturesque Eastern Himalayan Valley earlier this week. The toy train will run on a regular basis from Siliguri Junction to Rongtong Hill Station with a heritage steam engine and Vista Dome dining coach facilities. Tourists can enjoy the breathtaking views of Mahananda Wildlife Sanctuary and the hills from the train. This rail route in India is the most popular among national and international tourists travelling to the hill station of West Bengal because of its quaint route through tea plantations, long rocky stretches, hilly forests and deep moats.
This train is running from Siliguri to Rongtong and Rongtong via steam. It has two coaches, AC first class and a Vista Dome dining coach, which is very exciting. I think all the tourists who come to this region and the local people around who go for weekend tourists should avail this train and make this journey a very, very memorable one.
A railway official informed that during the three-hour journey to Rongtong, they will offer complimentary snacks and a cup of Darjeeling tea. The train would return to Siliguri on the same day. The regular toy train services were shut for the past few months due to the COVID-19 pandemic and resumed last week only.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.